Tunazama tena wangu kama
and look at the woman of God.
Kolini Apostle Koli.
Apostle Koli.
Praise the Lord.
Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes,
amen. Have your seat.
Yes, sir.
Have your seat. It's a blessing and a privilege to be given this opportunity to speak to you. If you're you have been listening to the pastor preach from Tuesday. Him, he's fast, very fast. He preaches. I teach. So if you're waiting for me to run, you might end up sleeping. So just open your heart. Take up your notebook. And your pen. And today let us learn. Amen.
Amen.
And if you have your Bible, open the book of 1 Peter. Are we all there? If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
Okay. We're going to read from verse 1 to verse 4. So I'll read and then you'll come after me. In like manner, you married women, be submissive to your own husbands. Subordinate yourselves as being secondary to and dependent on them, and adapt yourselves to them. Be your life of holy beauty. What matters is not your outer appearance, the styling of your hair, the jewelry you wear, the cut of your clothes, but your inner disposition. Cultivate inner beauty, the gentle, gracious kind that God delights in.
First Peter
chapter 3, verse 1 to 4. So we're going to focus on verse 4. And today we're going to learn about character. Tell your neighbor character. Not just good character, but godly character. When you look at 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1 to 4, it talks about a woman and how he should behave with a husband, whether they are ungodly or whether they are godly or not. But then in verse 4, it speaks about the kind of character that they should be having. And it talks about an inner beauty. Something that is more valuable than what is on the outside. And this applies to both men and women. Most of the time, we judge people or we look at people based on what we see. That is how we are wired as human beings. You look at what you see. But the Bible also talks about when God looks at us, he doesn't look at what man says, he looks at what the heart.
Yes.
So it gives us an idea that God values more what is on the heart than what we perceive on the outside. So woe unto you if you invest so much on your outside and you fail to invest on what is on the inside. We see it on the Bible over and over again when it talks about out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. We see it when God talks about true worship, worshiping God in truth and in spirit. Everything Everything that you're seeing right now on the outside, it's a reflection of what is on the inside. Everything you know about a person is a reflection of what is on their inside. So it is God's intention and purpose for you to be very mindful of what is on your inside. Your outward adornment does not impress God. What is on the inside is what is He is more paying attention to. So verse 4 talks about your inner beauty should consist of a gentle spirit. It should consist of kindness. It should consist of a tender heart. It should have humility in it. It talks about being polite. It talks about compassionate. These are the things that God calls unfading beauty. We hear so much when we're being taught about marriage. We are being told, don't look at what is on the outside, it fades. Look at what is on the inside. So what is this unfading beauty that God is talking about? You'll find it on verse 4. It's His full spirit, which is not anxious. So what is a gentle, what is a quiet spirit? A quiet spirit is a heart that can pause, intentionally focus on the present, be in the moment, and enjoy the simplicity of life. You see how we are wired as human beings. As women, as men, as young people, as youths, constantly you're thinking about tomorrow. What will I do tomorrow? Who will I become in the next 5 years? How is life looking at? Right now you're thinking about, we are ending the month next week, you need to be paying bills. We are constantly thinking about tomorrow. It is very rare for us to think about the now. So a quiet spirit promotes the idea of being in the moment. Right now, as you're in church, is your heart and your mind and your soul here? Or are you focusing on what you're going to be doing after service? Did you come to church wholeheartedly telling God, I want to sit in your presence and learn and not be distracted by anything? Or did you just come to church because it is a routine? Every Sunday we come to church. It's very important for you to take note. Since you started coming to church on January 1st, all the things that have been taught every Sunday, what difference has it made in your life? that is how you measure if you have been in the moment. Is there any difference since you started coming to church in 2024
in January?
Every lesson that has been taught here on Sunday, has it made you any fruitful? Can you stand in confidence and tell God, this one was preached on January, this date, and this is how it has manifested in my life? Are you able to stand and preach on what you have been taught? Or is your life even reflecting the lessons that you learned from here? Or you are those people that when you come out of church and they ask you how was church, unasema it was really powerful. But you cannot say anything that you were taught. Today the pastor was on fire. There was deliverance. Can you stand and tell another person who was not in church what you were taught, word to word? Do you even take notes? And that is how you build your faith. So ask your neighbor, are you here? Are you in the moment? Are you present? Or will you go back home and the only thing you will remember was that that girl was wearing a black and white cloth? Be intentional about being in the presence of God. Enjoy the simplicity of life. A quiet spirit is a heart that can release control to God and surrender to Him. If you're that person who is ever in control, you want to know everything is happening in details.
Kakati, in control of?
In control of your mind and your heart.
Okay.
Even when the Holy Spirit comes, you cannot cry. You're feeling the prompting that the Holy Spirit is in the room, but because you're in control, I don't want people to see me worshiping God. The Holy Spirit is leading you to kneel down and worship Him. I cannot, because I don't want people to see me. The problem of having a heart that you're not releasing is that God will never lead you. You will always be racing with God, forcing with God, wrestling with Him. Are you one of those people who say, kuna kitu iliniambia, kuna kitu inaniambianga, and you never follow what that thing is telling you? I wanted to do it. Kuna kitu naniambia.
Waliwo ekintu ekingamba munda munze.
You never pay attention to what the Holy Spirit is telling you.
Gwokanya kwogera bugezi waliwo ekingamba munda munze naye totuulaawo n'okkakkana n'owuliriza ekikugamba kikugamba ki.
That is why you cannot even give him credit and call him as in the form of a person. You're calling it it.
Chovola bachi esoba ito sona kumusima nogamba nti omwoyo omutukuvu azze gye ndi ogamba ekintu kyangambi ekintu kyangambi.
So how can you have a quiet spirit?
Osobola otya okuba n'omutima n'omutima oba omwoyo ogukakkanya oba oguwuliriza.
Before I tell you that, let me tell you what having a quiet spirit gives you.
Kati nga tanda batutwala eri kasooka tubuulire omutima ogukakkanya oba oguwuliriza gukuwaaki.
A quiet spirit gives you wisdom.
Omutima ogukakkana ne guwuliriza gukuwa amagezi.
Let us look at Proverbs 29:11.
Katuleko mu ngero 29:11.